Osteopathic Medicine's White Coat Ceremony for the class of 2027. My name is Kristen Anderson, and I am the Assistant Dean for Student Affairs and Nordicom's resident metalhead. It has been my distinct pleasure to have led Nordicom's efforts in recruiting this outstanding group of medical students who comprise the class of 2027. I am especially excited to have some of the pre-med students I advised in my past life in this cohort. While the White Coat Ceremony is a wonderful tradition, a thrilling and historic day at which we share in the pride of our students, their families, our faculty, and the entire campus community. Today we welcome a new class of Nordicom students who are beginning their medical school journey. They will spend countless hours studying, testing, and practicing their skills to become compassionate, competent, and confident osteopathic physicians. Thank you for being here to celebrate this milestone with us. As the ceremony begins, we ask that you show your respect for the students, their families, and for the college by silencing or turning off all cellular devices and by taking young children out of the arena if they become disruptive during the ceremony. Additionally, we ask that you remain seated during the procession so that all audience members can see the students. Finally, as the ceremony progresses, we ask that you do not crowd the walkways, as this could obstruct others' views or interfere with photography being taken throughout the event. Our processional is being led by our longest-serving faculty member, Dr. Stephen Prinster, Chair of the Biomedical Sciences Department. Let the processional begin. Would the platform party, students, and faculty please be seated? It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Norman S. Wright, President and Chief Executive Officer of the Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine.
Thank you, Kristen. Kristen is one of our genuinely committed team members who works unceasingly on behalf of the students. And good morning to all of you. Let me begin by offering my sincere thanks to the Utah Pipe Band for their inspiring processional. We're excited to have them with us today, including band member Dr. Andrew Barkley, who is an osteopathic physician with Intermountain Health. And there's just something about bagpipe music, or pivor music as it's known in Gaelic, that gives me energy and courage to face challenges. And let's face it, you're gonna face a few challenges over the next 4 years. Well, the Utah Pipe Band will also march us out on today's recessional, and if you would, please just join me in giving them a round of applause. Thank you, Utah Pipe Band. It's my great pleasure to welcome you to one of our most highly anticipated events of every year, the White Coat Ceremony. I love the White Coat Ceremony. It is a long-standing tradition, as you know, among medical schools, and serves as a public and special way to welcome medical students to the profession. But I love the White Coat Ceremony for another reason. As I met you, our students, and your families at the mixers, and your friends, and those who are supporting you, I see the pride of parents. I see parents who have been looking forward to this day for a long time. I see brothers and sisters, I see friends who look at you with respect and appreciation for your commitment to hard work and to enter this profession. And then I see your excitement, students, intelligence, maybe even a little anxiety and fear as you step out into this new world, which has for so long been your goal. I also, as I look at our faculty and staff members, I see a certain enthusiasm tempered by a sense of gravity in their eyes. As they renew their commitment to you, our students, and to the patients that you will serve throughout your lives. With all those emotions rooted in me today, it's with great joy that I congratulate and welcome you, Noorda's class of 2027. Now, in that spirit of elation and support, we're also pleased to have with us today members of the 2025 and 2026 classes, including the Student Government Association officers, class officers, and student ambassadors for the upcoming year. All these students are wonderful. They've embraced being a part of the NoordaCom family and are joining us today to welcome their COM 2027 colleagues. This speaks volumes about the culture that we and they are building here at NoordaCom, and their individual commitment to supporting you, their colleagues, as you go through this journey. A round of applause, if you would, for our students who are here in support. Now I would invite everyone to please stand for the presentation of the colors by the Air Force ROTC Detachment 855 of Brigham Young University and Utah Valley University. Please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem by student Dr. James Pike of our COM 2026 class and the invocation by Imam Shuaib Dean, Director of Religious Affairs at the Utah Islamic Center. Honor Guard, please present the colors.
say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you very much. Please be seated. Now I'd like to welcome to the stage Imam Shuaib Dean, Director of Religious Affairs at the Utah Islamic Center. Imam?
Let us pray. O God, creator of the universe and sustainer of all life, first and foremost, our heads bow down in gratitude to you for allowing us to witness this day where our children, our loved ones, have finally reached this momentous day, a long journey, the momentous day of fulfilling their lifelong dream, the first step of their journey. The students are now at their doorstep of fulfilling their dream. O God, O Allah, O Yahweh, we ask that you give them perseverance and discipline. O God, O Allah, O Yahweh, medicine is an arduous path, and they will have days of self-doubt. O Lord, creator of the universe and sustainer of one and all, remove their self-doubt and give them the confidence needed to succeed. They will be challenged. They will feel both exhilarated and frightened. We ask that you become their comforter and their console. O Lord, make each one of them a shoulder to lean on for their fellow students. O God, medicine is a noble profession in the world. They help people when they are in pain. O God, we believe that you are the sustainer of life and all cure comes from you. Make the class of 2027 the agents of cure in this world where you deliver cure through their hands. Teaching is also a very noble profession. O Allah, we ask that you give the professors and the administrators of Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine the strength and the wisdom to teach, to challenge and guide the students so that each student, week by week, month by month, and year after year, grows more and more than they thought was possible or could have ever imagined. O God, O Allah, O Yahweh, We ask that you accept our humble prayers in the name of Prophet Jesus Christ, and in the name of Prophet Moses, and in the name of Prophet Muhammad. Peace be upon all of them. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you, Imam Shuaib. We appreciate your inspirational words for your dedication. Our Imam has to return to another commitment, but as we were visiting before, I believe it's your son? Your daughter, sorry. His daughter was just attending her own white coat ceremony in Missouri last week or so. And so he knows what all of you were going to experience. So thank you again for being here today, Imam. Well, a word specifically to our students at this point. Thank you for letting me share this special moment with you and with your families as you embark on your journey towards becoming healers and lifesavers. And by the way, I saved a life this morning, just in case you're wondering. I took my dog for a walk, and we walked by the Provo River, and all of a sudden a little dog comes floating down the Provo River, and I got in up to my waist. So I join you in saving lives today. Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, when I joined Nordicom about 2 years ago, what immediately struck me was our team's commitment to our vision statement, which says, in part, to serve the individual and their community. Having spent my entire career in higher education, this idea was repeated often. It was less consistently lived. But what I saw then and what I see now in our Nordicom employees and students is that this campus is a place where people matter most. For our faculty and staff, this belief encourages us to put our students first, to deliver a quality, tech-forward education, to positively contribute to student wellness, and to create a supportive and inclusive campus environment with you at the center. What I ask of you, students, today is that you also adopt the motto that people matter most. As the Imam stated, you're going to face some hard times during your journey. There are going to be faculty, there are going to be staff members there supporting you along the way. As you go through those hard times, I would encourage you to remember the patients that you will serve in the future. Let them carry you through those hard moments. At the same time, I would ask that you strive for cooperation over competition. In 4 years' time, I want to see every one of you right back here receiving your diplomas and launching into your residencies with confidence and with additional competence. And let me just repeat that. I didn't say every one of you except for the two of you sitting over there. Every single one of you in 4 years' time. That's going to happen as you as a group value cooperation over competition. So, right now, I want you to turn to the person on your right, and then to the person on your left, give them a fist bump, a high five, a shake of the hand, and just let them know that you are there for them, and you're going to support them, and when it's your turn, you're going to turn to them for support. All right, thank you. Now, before I make a few brief introductions, allow me one more thought. By donning your white coat today, in public, and reciting your pledge of commitment, you are acknowledging your long-term decision to become a member of a most esteemed and caring profession and to accept the responsibilities that accompany that choice. Please remember that. Please take that commitment seriously, as I know that you will. And thank you for this, taking this pioneering step with us here at the Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine. It's my hope that you and I will always remember that it's the people we serve now and the people we serve in the future who matter most. And now it's my pleasure to introduce a few of our members of the platform party. So when I call your name, would you please stand and remain standing? And I ask the audience that you hold your applause until the entire platform party has been introduced. With us today on the stand, we have Francis Gibson, chair of the Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine Board of Trustees and a local hospital CEO. Dr. Karen Nichols has joined us. Dr. Nichols is the former president of the American Osteopathic Association. Our beloved Dr. John Doherty, founding dean and chief academic officer. Mr. Ralph House, chief financial officer. Dr. Michael Rhodes, associate dean for clinical affairs. Ms. Jennifer Brown, associate dean for academic affairs. Dr. Kyle Bills, associate dean for associate dean for research. Dr. Lindsay Drew, assistant dean for clinical education. Dr. Stephen Embley, assistant dean for clinical sciences and chair of medicine. Dr. Steve Prinster, chair of biomedical sciences. Dr. Tipsuda Junsanto Bari, faculty in pathology. Dr. Carlos Angulo, faculty in anatomy. Dr. Esther Neubel, faculty in biochemistry. Ms. Kristen Anderson, assistant dean for student affairs. Student Dr. Una Jensen, student government president, and student Dr. James Pike, student government officer for academic affairs. Thank you all for being here. We have several community leaders and NordaCom partners with us today. I invite them to stand as I introduce them and ask that we again hold applause until all have been introduced. These may not all be here, but I would like to acknowledge the founders of the Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine, Dr. Richard Nielsen, Dr. Michael Skurja, Mr. Gregory Stewart, who is here, and I hope he's standing by now, thank you, Mr. John Nemelka, NordaCom Board of Trustees members, former Utah Governor Gary Herbert, Ms. Linda Macon, and Greg Stewart, who's also been introduced already. NMS board members, Lachelle Shelley Stewart Sumbot, as well as Eric Stewart and Brittany Erickson of the Ray and Ty Noorda Family Foundation, and Andy Noorda and Carol Dumas of the Ray and Ty Noorda Family Foundation. In addition, congressional and legislative representatives, Utah County Commissioners, Provo and Orem City Council members, Provo Board of Education members, Mr. Curtis Blair, President and CEO of the Utah Valley Chamber of Commerce, representatives from the Utah Medical Association and the Utah Osteopathic Medical Association, and other community members, leaders, and healthcare partners. And finally, we would not be here today without the additional efforts of many in the community for whom we're grateful in dedicating their time and their energies to this great venture. Far too many to acknowledge individually, but thank you to all of these leaders in our community. I'm now pleased to introduce someone who's been with NordaCom for several years now and has been a great support. Mr. Francis Gibson, Chair of the NordaCom Board of Trustees, would you please come forward and deliver a few remarks? We're grateful for your service.
I was warned not to go off script, but that did not work, so I want to apologize for those who were standing behind me. I looked on the screen and I realized I take up a lot of space. And those who are behind me, you'll get to know very, very well, great faculty members. First, let me say, you're awesome. Not just awesome, but like freaking awesome. And we're so grateful to have you here. Now let me get back on script really quick, and I may jump again, but we'll stay on script. On behalf of NordaCom and the Board of Trustees, I am honored to be here today and to welcome you for this momentous occasion and important event in your lives. I say welcome to Utah. For some of you, this is your first time to the great state. Many mountains, rivers, streams, it's a beauty to behold, and we're welcoming you here. I moved here some 24 years ago from the state of Texas, and I've made this my home. This is a lot different than Texas. I hope that you will enjoy your time here and you will find this a great place to live. Just 3 years ago, we welcomed our first class of medical students to NordaCom. But the journey took the will, determination, and fortitude of many great individuals for many, many years. The vision of those individuals who saw the need for this medical school in our community was profound, and we quite literally would not be here today without the selfless and tireless work of many. I would like to acknowledge the leadership and support of the Ray and Ty Noorda Family Foundation, our founders, and countless others, including our board members and community leaders, all of whom have continued with Noorda College and to see that it become a reality. For your work on behalf of being and all of us being here today, we are immensely grateful. In addition to my role as chair of the NoordaCom board, I also serve as the CEO of a local hospital. In that role, I understand the challenges that Utah faces and related to healthcare. It has given me a keen understanding and significance of the importance of NoordaCom and the unique role in addressing the challenges of healthcare needs, not just in Utah, but nationwide. Utah continues to rank at the near to rank at or near the bottom nationally for the overall physicians to population ratio for primary care physicians, surgeons, and also female physicians. Add this to the dramatic population growth we are experiencing here in the state of Utah and the number of physicians retiring, it is easy to see the need that Utah has, not just now, but for opportunities moving forward and why NoordaCom is so important to us today. All the ingredients were here to create this unique opportunity. We have high quality healthcare. There is an entrepreneurial spirit and open-mindedness for most of all. We are blessed with some of the best and brightest students as part of our NoordaCom class. I'm so pleased that more than 50% of the students have ties to Utah. It is our hope that you will want to stay in this state and practice medicine after completing your school here and your residency programs. I too look forward to following many of your successes in the coming weeks, months, and years. But let me add, it's going to be hard. There are going to be days that you want to throw something. There are going to be days when you may want to use colorful language. There may be days that you shed tears. I'm off script, but I want to tell you, you have great, great faculty. People who have been where you are before. People that will grab your hand and help lead you and guide you. And people who want you to be successful. We are committed to seeing in 4 years all of you getting your degrees and moving on to a residency program that matters to you. I failed to mention a good friend who does a lot of PR for our school as a consultant by the name of Corey Malloy, and I wanted to make sure that he was thanked as well. Finally, if I can be of any assistance to you, please let me or any of our wonderful team reach out, grab your hand, and assist you and pull you forward. To your families, thank you for trusting us. Many of you have come from all over the state and all over the country, and we're glad that you're here. Finally, I say welcome to NoordaCom. Welcome to a great place. You're freaking awesome.
I don't see the phrase freaking awesome in here, but I like it. Yeah, it's probably worth mentioning that Representative Corey Malloy is in the state legislature, and we worked with him last year, or maybe it was a couple of years ago, to get passed a bill that would create additional residencies funded by the state of Utah here in Utah. And the beauty of that is it's going to give many of you in this graduating class a chance to stay here if that's your desire, because that will create, we're estimating 200, 300, maybe even 400 new residencies in the state of Utah over time. So thank you, Representative Malloy, and thank you, Chair Gibson, for your ongoing support. It's nice having someone with his years of experience, his colorful language, and his dedication to NoordaCom having my back. So before we bring forward our keynote speaker today, I would like to invite Dr. John Doherty, one of the most innovative people I know, our founding dean and chief academic officer, to come forward to offer remarks. Dr. Doherty?
Wow, guys, look where you are. Pretty nice, huh? Gotta feel pretty good, doesn't it? All right, so distinguished guests, faculty members, proud parents, and most importantly, this incredible class of aspiring osteopathic physicians. It is with great honor and pleasure that I stand before you today to celebrate your momentous occasion. To your parents, families, and loved ones who have supported you throughout this journey, we extend our deepest gratitude. Their unwavering encouragement and sacrifices have played an instrumental role in your success. They have witnessed your countless late nights of studying, your moments of self-doubt, not really, right? Never doubted it for a moment. Yeah, that's what I thought. And your steadfast determination. Today, we celebrate their love and overwhelming support as well. So let's take a moment, stand up, turn around, and wave and thank them, okay? Get off that chair for a second. Get up, find your family, and thank them. So this is what I like to say is one of your mom's special memory days. This is a day your mom will never forget, and she'll bring it up at the most awkward moment. You just watch. All right, well, the world marvels at technologic advancement and groundbreaking discoveries. We must never lose sight of the core principles that define our profession. Excuse me. Your training from this amazing faculty will emphasize the importance of empathy, active listening, building strong relationships with both your patients and with their families, treating them all with dignity and respect. You will learn to see the whole person, to recognize the individual behind the diagnosis, their fears, their hopes, their aspirations. Remember the power of the human touch, the value of a warm smile, and the impact of a listening ear. These small gestures can make the difference that to someone who is suffering that they may not get anywhere else. That is on you. I call this being a hero to someone that you are caring for. So my definition of hero is a little bit different from everybody else's. I define a hero as someone who is humble, empathetic, resilient, and open-minded. My goal is that each of you become heroes in your own communities and for your patients. And putting on these little white coats, you are taking the first steps towards becoming that hero. Today, I also challenge you to be advocates for change and champions of health equity. Our society is riddled with disparities, and it is your duty to ensure that everyone, regardless of their background or their circumstances, receives the quality health care they deserve. Be agents of change within your communities, driving forward initiatives that will bridge gaps in health care access and promote preventative medicine to help build a healthier society. As you embark on your medical education career and beyond, embrace every opportunity to learn and grow. Medicine is an ever-evolving field, and your commitment to lifelong learning will ensure that you stay at the forefront of medical knowledge. Seek mentors who inspire you. Mine's sitting back here. Embrace the wisdom of your colleagues, and never shy away from challenging the status quo. In closing, I want to remind you that your journey as osteopathic physicians will not be an easy one. You've heard that several times today. They're not fibbing. It will test your resilience, challenge your beliefs, and demand more from you than you have ever thought possible. But in those moments of adversity, you will find your true strength. Today, you join a proud lineage of osteopathic physicians who have dedicated their lives to the service of others. Carry that torch with honor. Carry it with compassion, humility. Embrace the privilege and responsibility that comes with wearing that white coat. And remember, above all, the greatest privilege of all is to be entrusted with the care and well-being of another human being. Congratulations, class of 2027. May your journey be filled with joy, purpose, and an unwavering commitment to make the world a healthier, more compassionate place. Okay, so I alluded to one of my mentors. I am very honored to have with us today Dr. Karen Nichols. Dr. Nichols most recently served as the Dean of Midwestern University Chicago College of Osteopathic Medicine. Previously, she served as the President of the American Osteopathic Association and the American College of Osteopathic Internists. Dr. Nichols is a trailblazer, a glass ceiling destroyer in the osteopathic position, and has been the first female to serve in those leadership roles. She is also the first of two DO physicians elected to the board of the Accreditation Council for Graduate Medical Education, and she was the first osteopathic chair of the ACGME. She's been a mentor and a voice of reason for many, many years. I'm sorry, she's just 29. And she is highly respected and is a regarded leader across the House of Medicine and has been an inspiration to a generation of leaders, myself included. We are very fortunate to have her with us today. Dr. Nichols, would you be so kind as to come forward?
So I've been a dean for several years, not much surprised me anymore. But that day, one of my staff burst into my office and she said, "Dr. Jones is on the phone and he is really mad." Now that was a surprise because Dr. Jones was our chief of surgery and he was very laid back, very calm. So I said, "Dr. Jones, this is Dr. Nichols. How can I help you?" And he said, "You can get Dr. Chad over here right now because my patient will not sign the surgical consent until Dr. Chad approves." Okay, so who is Dr. Chad? "Well, how should I know? He's one of your medical students." "Okay, we'll take care of that right away." So my staff checked, and there was a student, first named Chad, who was on surgical service. They got him over to the room, resolved the situation. In a couple of hours, I had student Dr. Chad in my office, and I knew him. He was a good student. He was strong academically. He was involved in student government. And I said, "So, I guess you had quite a dust up with Dr. Jones." And he said, "Yes." And I said, "So was this a family member of yours, this patient?" He said, "No." I said, "Well, was this patient somebody you knew outside of the hospital?" He said, "No." I said, "Well, did you tell her not to sign the surgical consent until you approved?" He said, "No." I said, "So, okay, why do you think that a patient would want the approval of a third-year medical student, smart as you are, in preference to the approval of the surgeon who is well-regarded?" He said, "I don't know." He said, "All I did was what you taught us, Dr. Nichols." I'm going, "Oh, no." So I said, "Okay, so what is that exactly?" And he said, "Well, you taught us to treat every patient as a human being." So I went back at the end of rounds every day, and I met with her, and I got acquainted with her, and maybe it was the dog. I'll tell you the rest of that story in a minute. So Congratulations, let me be one more person to congratulate you, Noorda Com Class of 2027. So as you just heard, I have known your dean for many years. He is without a doubt the most focused person, laser focused on you having an excellent medical education and training experience. He's incredibly innovative, and I think you know that, or that's probably why you chose this school. And I would also have to say that my remarks are going to see, you're going to see some similarities with his. We did not compare notes. So let me tell you what my three pieces of advice are for you to become an excellent physician. You have to have wisdom, knowledge, and caring. Wisdom, now that's going to come with time. Knowledge, you will be building your storehouse of knowledge over your period of time at Noorda. But I would submit on the point of caring, you have that now. So I want to give you two examples about what it means to me as a physician with a lot of years under my belt of what caring actually means. So back when I was in private practice, I was seeing patients one afternoon. The next patient was new to the practice. I did not know the name. I walked into the room to introduce myself, and she literally jumped off the table, and she grabbed me in a big bear hug, and I pulled back, and she said, "Oh, I know you don't remember me," but she said, "9 years ago, you took care of my mother in the hospital, and you came back at the end of the day to check on her, and the whole family was there, so you started to explain to us and the patient what was going on." And she was laying there and she was shivering and she was cold. She was this little bit of a thing. And in the middle of your conversation, you stopped and you said, "I'll be right back." You walked out of the room and you came back in a couple minutes with a blanket from the warming cabinet. And you laid it across her, and then you went back and tucked her in like she was a little kid, and she got warm and she relaxed and fell asleep. And I swore if I ever had the chance, I would pick you to be my doctor because of the incredible empathy that you showed to my mother. So that's one point about caring. You have to have empathy. Now, the second story I'm going to tell you is not actually medical, but you'll get it. So, Daniel Shore was a political pundit who was so wise and so thoughtful, and he's long gone. But I heard him interviewed one time, and they said, "So, how did you get started to be such a successful political commentator?" And he said, "Well, when I was a cub reporter, I went to my very first editor and I said, what do I have to do to be really good at reporting? And the editor said, well, you have to be sincere. When you're interviewing your subject, you have to be sincere and interested in them, or you're not going to find out what really happened. You're not going to get the backstory. And when you're reporting that story, if you're not sincere, you're not going to make a connection with your audience, and they're not really going to care what you have written." He said, sincerity, that's the key. When you can fake that, you'll be fine. So, of course, you can't fake sincerity. Studies have shown that patients assess their doctors to determine how much they trust them, if they will trust them, in the first 18 seconds. So empathy, sincerity, those are two of the very important aspects of caring. And I received that message when I was a medical student from one of my faculty. He said, your patients don't care what you know until they know that you care. So you've chosen an excellent degree, a fine school, and a wonderful profession. And I want to make an observation that may seem a little odd. This is more your profession than it is mine. I know I've served in every aspect, led every aspect, but consider how many thousands of patients that the Noorda class of 2027 is going to take care of. It's your profession. Take good care of it. So, you want to hear the rest of the Dr. Chad story? Okay. So he said, okay, I came back to see that patient at the end of the day and get acquainted with her. And I found out she really didn't have any family members in the state, and she didn't have many friends or acquaintances left, but she doted on her dog, and the dog's name was Rover. So every day at the end of rounds, I would come back and she would tell me stories about Rover and stories about Rover. So maybe that was the reason that she wanted my opinion about whether that surgical consent was appropriate for her to sign because we had made such a human-to-human connection. So in conclusion, I recommend that you aspire to wisdom, build your knowledge, and never, never, never stray away from your caring that you feel right now. And I want to add one piece of advice that I learned from Dr. Chad. Find out the name of the dog.
Thank you, Dr. Nichols. Okay, it's time. You guys ready for this? All right, so will the osteopathic medical students please stand and make your way to the front of the stage. As they come forward, our students will state their name, their hometown, and their undergraduate institution. So can I have Dr. Rhodes, Drs. Drew, Embley, Angula, and Bari, who assist with the white coating, come please join me on stage. And Dr. Wright will be joining me to congratulate the students at the edge of the stage. Are you ready? All right.
Jacob Adams, Draper, Utah, University of Utah.
Olivia Adepaju, Williamstown, New Jersey, American University.
Lamia Alam, I'm from Los Angeles, California, and I graduated from University of California, Riverside.
Luis Alvarez, Orlando, Florida, University of South Florida. Go Bulls.
Jaron Anderson from Annabella, Utah, graduated from Utah Tech University.
Aaron John Andrews, I'm from Shelley, Idaho, Southern Virginia University.
Conrad Ashby, Pleasant Grove, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Saren Lee Baker, Fullerton, California, Brigham Young University.
Alex Barber, Johnstown, Colorado, Colorado State University.
James Barber III, Enola, Pennsylvania, the University of Pittsburgh.
Tanner Brain, East Mill Creek, Utah, University of Utah.
Daniela Blanco, Palm Beach, Florida, Florida Atlantic University.
Braden Black, Roy, Utah, University of Utah.
Josh Barton, Cedar City, Utah, Southern Utah University.
Kinsley Batson, Broomfield, Colorado, Utah State University.
Ron Bada, Buffalo, New York, Union College, Go Bills.
Elliot Beard, Vienna, Virginia, BYU, Hawaii.
Caitlin Beachey-Ierley, Bloomsburg, Pennsylvania, Bloomsburg University of Pennsylvania.
Paul Bejarano, Tucson, Arizona, University of Arizona, bear down, baby.
Kennedy Birdsey, Rutland, Vermont, and University of Vermont.
Amanda Brandardis, Stansbury Park, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Cassidy Bean Byers, Sammamish, Washington, Brigham Young University.
Mariana Chacon, Phoenix, Arizona, University of Arizona.
Todd Chen, San Francisco, California, University of Utah. Let's go Niners.
Daniel Cho, Honolulu, Hawaii, University of California at Los Angeles.
Sam Christensen, Kaysville, Utah, the University of Utah.
Nesta Cruz, Vineland, New Jersey, Rowan University.
Nick Curtis, Alpine, Utah, BYU Cougars.
Alex Dow, Lake Forest, California, University of San Diego.
Robert Darby, from Kode, Japan, University of Washington.
Charles Fleischman, San Francisco, California, Reed College.
Porter Fife, Harriman, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Hayden Evans, Queen Creek, Arizona, Arizona State University.
Reedy Dave, Oakdale, Connecticut, University of Connecticut.
Miles DeBry, East Mill Creek, Utah, BYU, Hawaii.
Sophia Delgado, Miami, Florida, Florida International University.
Eric Demerill, Green Bay, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Madison.
Sumbul Doshad, Lodi, California, UC Davis. Salam, Mom and Dad.
Matthew Dolinar, Buffalo, New York, Siena College, Go Bills.
Davis Elm, Green Bay, Wisconsin, University of Utah.
Branson Fonsbeck, Riverside, Utah, Weber State University.
Hannah Freeman, Meridian, Idaho, and Boise State University.
Levi Fredrickson, Battleground, Washington, Eastern Washington University.
Diane Gabriel, I'm from St. Augustine, Florida, and I attended the University of North Florida.
Hi, my name is Sara Polonia Garcia. I am from San Francisco, California, and I went to University of San Francisco.
Eric Gardner, Ogden, Utah, Utah State.
Gabrielle Gaudet. I'm from Maple Grove, Minnesota, and I went to the University of Utah.
Ammon Gerber, West Point, New York, BYU.
Alexandria Gerhardy, Buffalo, New York, and Niagara University.
Cody Gibson Young, also known as the guy with the Southern accent, Athens, Alabama, Athens State University.
Elias Maximiliano Gonzalez, San Antonio, Texas, St. Mary's University.
Christopher Gowans, Orem, Utah, Utah Valley University.
Ivania Gray, Harriman, Utah, the University of Utah.
Natalie Page Griffin, Fort Worth, Texas, Suwannee, the University of the South.
Justin Guffey, Snohomish, Washington, the University of Washington.
Ethan Hampton, Highland, Utah, Southern Utah University.
Joseph Harbold, Pleasant Grove, Utah, Brigham Young University, Idaho.
Blake Harris from Orem, Utah, Utah Valley University.
Costner Henson, Thousand Oaks, California, Brigham Young University.
Jacob Hill from Orem, Utah, Utah Valley University.
Richard Huang, Taipei, Taiwan, University of Arizona.
Jordan Hecker, Belmont, North Carolina, the University of North Carolina.
My name is Macy Hughes. I'm from Lampasas, Texas, and I graduated from Texas A&M University. Woo!
Lindsay Humphrey, Leadville, Colorado, University of Colorado, Boulder.
Hannah Hunsaker, Park City, Utah, Williams College.
Mindy Huynh, San Francisco, California, University of California, Davis.
Corinna Hyland, Springfield, Missouri, Gustavus Adolphus College.
James Iwanu, Los Angeles, California, Brigham Young University.
Chinyera Rosemary Iwanu, Houston, Texas, the University of Pittsburgh.
Jiv Jacob, Marlboro, New Jersey, Monmouth University.
Zachary Jamis, Cape Cod, Massachusetts, UMass Dartmouth.
Hello, I'm Julian Harkin from Los Angeles, California, and I attended Cal State Northridge.
Aurora Jeans, Phoenix, Arizona, Northern Arizona University.
Connor Jenkins, born and raised West Jordan, Utah, University of Utah. Go Utes!
Eldon Jenkins, West Jordan, Utah, University of Utah.
Millicent Joe, Westwood, Massachusetts, New York University.
Brian Jimenez, Washburn, Missouri, Brigham Young University, Idaho.
Kevin Johnson, Oak Harbor, Washington, Gonzaga University.
Celine Kerdak, San Diego, California, and the University of California, San Diego.
Nancy Koshel, Placero, California, University of California, Santa Cruz.
Brianna Keene, Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, Harvard University.
Daniel Keyes from Portland, Oregon, and I graduated from Brigham Young University and Utah Valley University.
Nathan Kobus, Lincoln, Nebraska, University of Nebraska, Lincoln.
Paul Croft Kokerhans II, Linden, Utah, Utah Valley University.
Alex Kovaleski, Springfield, Ohio, Franklin University.
Leah H. Flitterman Kramer, Agoura Hills, California, University of California, Santa Cruz.
Divya Lahori, Baltimore, Maryland, University of Maryland, College Park.
Aveline Langmead, San Diego, California, Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo.
Alicia Larson, Des Moines, Iowa, University of Iowa.
Alfonso Lopez Jr., Salt Lake City, Utah, by way of La Huerta, Jalisco, Mexico, the University of Utah.
Felipe Alejandro Lopez Diaz, Calexico, California, Mexicali, Mexico, Cal State University, Channel Islands.
Amanda Lee, Roseville, California, University of California, Davis.
Kennedy Madrid, Rancho Cucamonga, California, Brigham Young University.
Devin McBee, Irvine, California, Brigham Young University.
Macy McBride, Blackfoot, Idaho, Idaho State University.
Julie McGrody, Holbrook, New York, Stony Brook University.
Amanda McKenna, Sacramento, California, University of California, Santa Barbara.
Sarah McMahon, Tucson, Arizona, the University of Arizona.
Jared Michaels, Reidsville, Pennsylvania, Lebanon Valley College.
Louis Michelon, Medford, Oregon, Oregon Institute of Technology.
Michael Stephen Milius, Mesa, Arizona, Utah Valley University.
Jaden Miner, West Jordan, Utah, University of Utah.
Kyle Mude, Los Alamos, New Mexico, the University of New Mexico.
Emilia Moore, Muskegon Heights, Michigan, Western Michigan University.
Trevor Moore, Fort Myers, Florida, University of Central Florida.
Drew Mortensen, Phoenix, Arizona, BYU.
Mark Mortensen, Mapleton, Utah, Utah State University.
Justin Morwood, Beaver, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Mashua Moshraf, Cheshire, Connecticut, University of Connecticut.
Talon Muelstein, Oakley, Idaho, BYU, Idaho.
Ryan Murdoch, Blackfoot, Idaho, Pacific Lutheran University.
I'm Aliza Namit from Chico, California, and I attended California State University, Chico. Go Wildcats.
I'm Ethan Nelson. I'm from Hemet, California, BYU.
I'm Lauren Nelson. I went to Marquette University and I'm from Bettendorf, Iowa.
Brian Newman, Reno, Nevada, Brigham Young University, Idaho.
Tiffany Nguyen, Santa Barbara, California, University of California, Davis.
Shabnam Nushin, Huntington Beach, California, UC Berkeley.
Aratara Atha Nitrin, Burke, Virginia, University of Virginia.
Nate Nyberg, St. George, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Caroline O'Neill, Issaquah, Washington, Washington State University.
Omawumi Oladipo, Oakland, California, University of California, Riverside.
Katie Older, Augusta, Georgia, University of Idaho.
Steve Olson, Calgary, Alberta, Brigham Young University.
Amanda Page, Mesa, Arizona, Northern Arizona University.
Monil Patel, Long Island, New York, Hofstra University.
Payal Patel, Fremont, California, New York University.
Preena Patel, St. George, Utah, UCLA.
Zachary Paxton, Bountiful, Utah, Utah State University.
John Pelham, Fredericksburg, Virginia, Virginia Commonwealth University.
Christian Perez, San Pedro, California, Biola University.
Lixlia Perez-Plannell, Fredericksburg, Virginia, James Madison University.
Garrett Phillips, Rock Springs, Wyoming, University of Wyoming.
Neil Prakash, Bloomfield Hills, Michigan, Michigan State University.
Eitan Quintoriano, Brooklyn, New York, the University of South Florida.
Daniel Ramirez, Harlingen, Texas, St. Mary's University and Colorado State University.
Yahya Rashid, Chicago, Illinois, Loyola University, Chicago. Go Ramblers.
My name is Neha Ratna. I'm from Dallas, Texas, and I attended Cornell University.
Clayton David Rawson, Orem, Utah, Utah Valley University.
Josh Reese, Heber City, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Layla Risden, Seattle, Washington, University of Washington.
Alessandra Macy Lee Rivera, Cerritos, California, University of San Francisco.
Andrew Ross, Marietta, California, Brigham Young University.
Alexander Ruiz, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Duquesne University.
Catherine Yvonne Russell, Idaho Falls, Idaho, BYU Idaho, class of 2002, more recently, Utah Valley University, go Wolverines.
Daoud Sajadi, Iowa State University, Minneapolis, Minnesota. Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Bhavan Sajdani, Lake Zurich, Illinois, University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign.
Sayed Saleh, Chico, California, California State University, Chico.
Shelby Salinas, Rialto, California, University of California, San Diego.
Luke Earl Sanders, Salt Lake City, Utah, the University of Utah.
Sydney Sands, Draper, Utah, Brigham Young University.
Elizabeth Sarkeesian from Valencia, California, graduated California State University of Northridge.
Swathi Senthil, Dublin, California, University of California, San Diego.
Ryan Shaw, Surprise, Arizona, Arizona State University. While I got this time, I want to say thank you to all my family. I wouldn't have made it here without their love and support.
Ilram Shamoon, Turlock, California, despite moving around a lot, CSU Stanislaus.
Joseph Sherman, Mesa, Arizona, Brigham Young University.
Alan Shoemaker, Tucson, Arizona, the University of Arizona. Bear down.
Kieran Single, Philadelphia, PA, St. Louis University.
Rebecca Smythe, Boulder City, Nevada, and University of Nevada, Las Vegas.
Tori Spector, Farmington Hills, Michigan, University of Michigan.
Jasmine Tran, Yuba City, California, University of California, Davis.
Jane Studer, Sacramento, California, University of Nevada, Reno.
Diane Sun, Los Angeles, California, Cal State Long Beach.
Christopher Swart, Marietta, Georgia, University of Georgia, Go Dogs.
Zach Ta, I'm from West Jordan, Utah, and I graduate from the University of Utah.
Omar Taher from Ann Arbor, Michigan, Michigan State University.
Hello, my name is Alexander Tam. I'm from Libertyville, Illinois, and I graduated from Miami University.
Natalie Tate, Aliso Viejo, California, Cornell University.
Shirley Tadros, Los Angeles, California, University of California, Riverside.
Chase Taylor, Mesa, Arizona, Brigham Young University.
Isabella Termini, Long Island, New York, Nova Southeastern University.
Brock Thatcher, Henderson, Nevada, Brigham Young University.
Anupa Thermaya, Orlando, Florida, University of Central Florida.
Dallin Thornton, Mesa, Arizona, Arizona State University.
Boyd Tisdale from Ahoskie, North Carolina, University of North Carolina.
Vincent Tran, Longmont, Colorado, University of Colorado at Boulder. Let's go Buffs.
Mike Trapnell from Mapleton, Utah, and Brigham Young University.
Marco Treviño, Weslaco, Texas, University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley.
Stephanie Trofimenko, Tucson, Arizona, the University of Arizona.
Hi, Nayel Odin from Seattle, Washington, and I attended the University of Washington. Go Huskies.
Zedo Swan, Dayton, Ohio, the Ohio State University.
Tiago Vecchi, Sao Paulo, Brazil, Utah Valley University.
Garrett Vincent, Laguna Niguel, California, Brigham Young University.
Alexandria Vo, Houston, Texas, Colorado School of Mines.
Kelly Vogel, East Troy, Wisconsin, University of Wisconsin-Eau Claire.
Jacob Warner, Alpine, Utah, Brigham Young University.
I'm Megan Wilkie from Temecula, California, and I attended the University of New Mexico.
Isaac Young, Hudson, Wisconsin, Creighton University.
Umber Zephyr, Edison, New Jersey, Drexel University.
Ethan Zog, Chugiak, Alaska, Brigham Young University.
Now, will the class of 2027 please rise? Family and friends, let's give them a round of applause. I've learned you never cut off a mom while she's clapping. Okay, now I would like to invite Dr. Karen Nichols back to the podium, and she will lead you all in reciting the Osteopathic Pledge. The pledge can be found in your program. Dr. Nichols.
Okay, and we also invite all of the osteopathic physicians to stand and join us in reciting the pledge. Okay, and say it like you mean it. All right. I pledge to provide compassionate, quality care to my patients, partner with them to promote health, display integrity and professionalism throughout my career, advance the philosophy, practice, and science of osteopathic medicine, continue lifelong learning, support my profession with loyalty in action, word, and deed, and live each day as an example of what an osteopathic physician should be. Congratulations.
Okay, you guys can have it seated. So now I am pleased to invite student Dr. Una Jensen, the student government president. She's going to come forward and sing for you. No. Immediately following student Dr. Jensen's comments, Dr. Wright will return for closing remarks. Student Dr. Jensen.
First and foremost, I want to extend the warmest welcome and offer my biggest congratulations to the incoming class of 2027. So excited for you guys. I wish that you feel accomplished beyond belief. I hope that you're spoiled today by friends and family. And I hope that when you face Foundations of Medicine on Monday, that you greet it with the calmest of nerves. I promise you're gonna be just okay. No, not just okay, you'll be great, you'll do great. Okay. I truly believe that many of us seated here today chose to become physicians of osteopathic medicine because we have kind hearts. Although we may not have expressed it so explicitly in our applications here, our deepest desires lie in wanting to help people with compassion and empathy. Today, I'd like to share several reminders of kindness as you begin, and for many of us continue, our medical journey. Be kind to your colleagues. The individuals that you are seated next to right now are going to be some of your greatest supporters, your closest friends, and your extended family. I can personally tell you about experiences I've shared with my own classmates, where we've celebrated test scores, calmed each other's nerves, welcomed new family members and babies, mourned personal losses, and uplifted each other when everything seemed too hard. I can promise you will share similar experiences with these new friends and our future patients. Be kind to your faculty and teachers. Medicine is really challenging. It is complex, it's ever-changing, and it's especially frustrating. Teaching medicine, though, must be a whole nother beast. Always showcase patience and support to those who are teaching, as our profession requires us to constantly learn and eventually teach as well. Be kind to yourself. This may be the most difficult of all for some. And I can personally share that this is a struggle I've experienced as well. We will experience massive victories. I hope today is one of them. However, we will also face failures in classwork, in the professional field, with uncontrollable outcomes, and in our personal lives. In these times, when it's most uncomfortable to support ourselves and avoid self-blame, it will be most beneficial for all if we treat ourselves with the same kindness we would give others and move past failures. In all that we do, let us be kind. Let us be kind in all things so that we may showcase empathy and compassion for those patients who will soon approach us in their most vulnerable and fearful states. Let us listen to the kind hearts that have led us this far so that we can be the best that we can be. Congratulations again to the class of 2027 and welcome to our NoordaCom family. Go Gnomes!
You know, we have had some absolutely frickin' awesome student government officers. And I mean that very sincerely. These folks have been committed. They've done a great job. They provided insights that we needed to help you. And Una is very much, student Dr. Jensen is very much in that tradition. So thank you, student Dr. Jensen, for your inspiring welcome to our fellow gnomes. Now, what a great day this has been. What a great time together this has been, full of inspiration and beautiful traditions. And obviously, I know I'm the last barrier between you and your loved ones, as well as my own lunch, so I'm going to keep the rest of this very brief. On behalf of the entire NoordaCom community, I would like to say first thank you to the parents, siblings, partners, spouses, children, and other family and friends of our white coat recipients. We know that this takes more than just one incredibly hardworking, dedicated, and very intelligent individual to get this person to become a doctor. We know it's not possible without your support and your sacrifice, and we are grateful for that. And I do applaud you for your support. Now, students, I am absolutely looking forward to working with you over the next 4 years. One of you, and I can't remember your name, I apologize for that, I think you're a Weber State graduate, but showed up in shorts and working boots for our day of service yesterday, looking great, and worked his backside off, and I know that you know how to work hard. I'm excited to spend time with you. I appreciate just seeing your passion and your commitment that you've put forward to get to this moment, and I just thrive on that. You inspire me on a daily basis. So, let me mention just a couple things. One thought, one brief story. Students, oh, by the way, Dr. Nichols, thank you for your remarks. And the name of my dog this morning was Maisie. All right. So, first of all, students, if you're feeling imposter syndrome, if you're feeling like maybe you don't belong, if you're looking at that incredible person on your left and the incredible person on your right and thinking, oh, do I belong here? If you're experiencing imposter syndrome, let me give you a prescription. You can apply it liberally 3 times a day. Stop it. Just stop it now. You belong here. And I'm dead serious about that. You belong here. We've got really smart people who make admissions decisions here at NoordaCom. We're backed by world-class AI and big data analytics. We chose you because we know you can be successful and that you will. So, practice humility to learn from our tremendously capable and caring professors. Practice love of yourself, as was mentioned, and love of each other. When you look at these faculty members in front of you and around you, their number one goal, it's just to help you accomplish your goal, to become doctors, to become capable and caring doctors. That's their entire professional goal at this stage of their lives. And so with their help, your hard work, and by supporting each other, you'll make it, we'll get you there. Now, to the second point. And this is a little bit of a story. Each year, Provo puts on this wonderful parade. It's a really big celebration for the 4th of July put on by a group called the Freedom Foundation. And so it's my pleasure as the president of NoordaCom to represent our school and to ride through the parade in some fantastic automobile that I can't afford. This year's vehicle was a 1967 Ford Mustang convertible that was absolutely superb. As we ride down the parade route, there are announcers stationed every couple of blocks or something who say, "And now, representing the Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine, Norman Wright, riding in a 1967 Ford Mustang, da-da-da." And so they go through that. Now, the only challenge is that there are some of these announcers who can't really pronounce Noorda College of Osteopathic Medicine. So I'm going down the route, and I'm listening, you know, and you hear the announcers, and you know, some of them are doing pretty well. And then I get to one, and they're like, "And now is Norman Wright, president of Noorda College of Osteopathetic Medicine." You can imagine my delight and horror all at the same time. It was absolutely wonderful. Let me just be clear. From this school will go competent, confident, and compassionate doctors of osteopathic medicine, not osteopathetic doctors. So start adopting that motto now of caring for each other and that people matter most by helping those around you to succeed and having the courage to reach out to them and to us when you're hitting your walls. By being both supportive and vulnerable, we take the pathetic out of osteopathic. Welcome to Nordicom University. We are so delighted that you are here. Now, as we conclude, I'd ask that members of the audience remain seated until the platform party, faculty, and students have completed the recessional so that others can see their loved ones pass by. And with that, let the recessional begin.
but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Been waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child.
I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have. 'Cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down.
'Cause I'm on top of the world, yeah. I'm on top of the world, yeah. Been waiting on this for a while now. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world. I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world.